Good day and welcome back. Today we're going to talk about the last topic in chapter 16, that is Hall effect. At the end of this video, you should be able to explain what is Hall effect and state its application. And then we're going to derive an expression for the Hall voltage. Before this, we have learned what happened to the conductor when it is placed in a magnetic field. Now we're going to look into the internal of the conductor. When there is a current flowing through the conductor, so there will be a charge carrier moving in the conductor. For example, we have the positive charge moving to the right in this case. So we have learned that there will be a magnetic force acted on the moving charge. By using the Fleming left-hand rule, the magnetic force acted on the moving charge here is in upward directions. So the positive charge will be deflected to the top surface, which causes the top surface to be positively charged and also the lower surface to be negatively charged. The process is keep repeating until there is an electric field set up in vertical to the direction of the current flow. So we will have additional of electrostatic force acted on the moving charge, which cancel the magnetic force. In the end, the moving charge able to move horizontally along the wire conductor. Next, we're going to look through second example, which is about the electron. So the electron is flowing in the direction opposite to the current flow. So the electron will move to the left in this case. Apply the Fleming left-hand rule. The magnetic force acted on the electron is also in upward directions. So this caused the upper surface to be negatively charged while leaving the lower surface to be positively charged. In the end, the electron also able to move in a horizontal line along the wire conductor. So based on this case, we actually can determine the type of the charge carrier in a wire conductor, especially for the semiconductor applications. We have learned about the doping that we can produce two types of semiconductor, which include the P-type and N-type semiconductor. The major charge carrier in the P-type and N-type semiconductor is the positive charge and the negative charge respectively. So now we have understand what is Hall effect. It is a phenomenon that we have a transverse voltage in the current carrying conductor when it is placed in the magnetic field. The word transverse here is opposite to the word longitudinal, that the voltage is perpendicular to the direction of the current flow. To derive the Hall voltage, so let's start with the equations of the electrostatic force is equal to the magnetic force as discussed just now. Put in the formula above these forces, and then we can substitute the electric field strength as the ratio of the Hall voltage to the distance between the upper surface and the lower surface. And then we can obtain the expression of the Hall voltage equal to dVB. Then we also can further derive the Hall voltage in terms of the current. From chapter 14, we have learned about current is equal to nav. So we can substitute the drift velocity of electron equal to I divided by NAE, rearrange the formula, and then we can substitute the D over A is the reciprocal of the thickness of the wire. In the end, the Hall voltage is equal to IB over net, where T is the thickness or the width of the conductor. The derivations and the formula here is quite straightforward. Let's try one question from past year in 2019. So you're given with this setup that the Hall voltage is equal to 4 millivolt, current 0.026 ampere, and the magnetic field strength is 2 tesla. So we are going to calculate the drift velocity and the density of the free electron. So remember that we start the derivations with the electrostatic force equal to the magnetic force, and then we obtain the equations of BH equal to dVB. So we can calculate the drift velocity of the electron as the ratio of the Hall voltage to dB. Put in all the value, and you can obtain the drift velocity equal to 0.4 meter per second. And then to calculate the density of free electron, we have the formula of BH equal to IB over net. So the electron density is equal to IB divided by VET. Put in all the value, then you can obtain the electron density equal to 4.06 multiplied 10 to the power of 22 per meter cube. So last but not least, we're going to list a few applications of the Hall effect. From the earlier discussion, the Hall effect can be used to determine the type of charge carrier, especially for the semiconductor. Then there is another instrument called the Hall probe that can measure the magnetic flux density. There will be more applications of the Hall effect. From the past year questions, we have learned how to calculate the drift velocity and the density of the free electron in the conductor. This is especially useful for the semiconductor, which has lower electron density than in the metal. Due to the lower electron density in the semiconductor, higher Hall voltage can be measured in a semiconductor. So that's all for my discussion today. If you have any questions, you can leave it in the comment section below. Also, do leave a like, share my video, and subscribe my channel. See you in my next video. Thank you.